Dear Supriya, thank you for accepting the interview. I have some questions for you. The first one is, could you please share your opinion? What was the main factor that drove the European countries into the financial crisis?
Well, several countries in the Eurozone have faced deficits, because of which the economies have slowed down. There has been a massive slowdown in the economy. There have been expensive bailouts. The government is funding the banks and the economy. There are high interest rates. This has actually led to a lot of pressure on the governments. International Monetary Fund and the European Union, all of these are helping bail out in exchange for refunds. But actually, the problem started as many countries had asset bubbles, because of which during the Great Recessions, when the financial crises were actually coming up. So many countries had asset bubbles, because of which the capital was flowing from the strong countries to the weaker countries. This led the policymakers basically to increase their public spending. And when these asset bubbles actually popped up, then the result was massive bank losses. There were huge bank losses. There were even larger deficits, because the deficits were already there in the economy, and it led to even larger deficits then. So that's how the problem of the Eurozone financial crisis started. So, yeah.
Thank you. My second question is the euro factor monetary union playing any role in solving this crisis?
Well, yes. After the financial crisis, all these authorities have become very vigilant now. But since more than 2 years, the European Central Bank and the other central banks have actually initiated a macroprudential research network, that's also called MIRDEC. And it basically integrates the financial instabilities held in the transmission mechanisms, and so that's the function of the macroprudential research network. Then the other thing that that has been formed is the European Financial Stability Funding. Now that's a very important initiative that has been found since the recent crisis, and this is more like an emergency funding program. And through this program, many countries have been funded on emergency basis, for example, including Ireland, Spain, Portugal, and of course, Greece. Then I think another one, more role that the central banks play in the act of this is they act as the stabilizing force to the sovereign debt market.
What are the main problems of banking sector in Europe?
Banks have always been very important for the entire economy. They are the most important financial intermediaries in the economy, where they help the lenders, they deposit money, and then they facilitate loans for the borrowers who want money for future investment purposes or other ventures. So, but lately, during the crisis and since then, the banks are facing a few problems now, including, for example, the low interest rate. We see many countries, especially in the euro area, have zero interest rates. They have negative interest rates as well, which has actually lowered the revenue of the banks. That's one problem. The second is, I would say, non-performing loans for the banks. Now, non-performing loan is any loan that is more like a default if it's not started to be repaid after 90 days. So non-performing loans is a problem. And let me just point out that it's not just the Italian banks that have the bad loans, but there are many other countries, central banks and other banks are facing non-performing loans. And most of the banks are now unwilling to sell the non-performing loans because of the added cost that they have, because they've already incurred that loss, and now they have they would rather restrict selling the non-performing loans further. Then I would say one very important problem that the banks facing right now is the problem of regulation. Now that aspect is the least growing in the banking sector. So the banks really need some regulation, some strict regulation rules, so that it helps them to perform better in future now. And lastly, I think all these factors, and of course the other factors that cause problems, causing problems in the banking sector now, have led to a fall in profitability of banks, which is very important. The banks are having earning low profits, which again is a problem, of course, for the entire economy as well.
My last question for you, Supriya, is do you have any reform suggestion for such countries like Greece, Spain, Italy and Portugal?
See, first and foremost, this country needs to have more coordinated macro policy approach. That's very important. At the euro level at least, they need to have a very strong macro policy approach. Then there's a lot of discussion about structural reforms. So there should be implementation of structural reforms and introduction of contractual programs along with support for implementation of these programs. There are certain countries that are weak enough in implementing such programs. So that's very important. If you have those programs, you do implement, you do have put forward the structural reforms. But at the same time, I think it's very important to provide them with support in order to implement those reforms. Then next, I would say, let's say a strong economic and monetary union actually requires a greater parliamentary control of economic policies at the national level. That's very important. It is very important to give control and a bit of control to the parliamentary organizations at every country, at a country level, at a national level, in the formulation of these economic policies. And lastly, a suggestion, one suggestion that I would like to give is strict banking reforms, because all the crises have directly or indirectly, banks play a very important role in all these crises. So it's very important to have strict banking reforms, for example, capital requirements. Now, before, during Basel 1, Basel 2, capital requirements were much talked about and everything. And just after these crises now, suddenly liquidity requirements have become very important. So yes, there should be better capital requirements. There must be strict liquidity requirements. Recently, in 2015, Basel III has introduced the two ratios to measure the liquidity requirements, which is the liquidity coverage ratio and the net stable funding ratio. Now, it's very important for these banks to maintain these ratios, maintain proper liquidity requirements, have better risk measurements. And so, yeah, I would suggest that these reforms, along with, of course, other reforms by the central bank, by the ECB, they would really help to create, wind up these crises in a better manner. So, yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.